You're watching the News Hour Special Edition.
Welcome back on to the second debate this Sunday evening. A day after Sonu Nigam, in an explosive interview to Times Now, said that there is a Bollywood mafia not just against newbie actors but in the music industry as well. Ace composer, music maestro, Oscar winner A.R. Rahman has now come out and said that there is a gang in Bollywood which is working against him, due to which he's not getting many movies, especially in the Hindi movie space. Meanwhile, Mumbai cops have also summoned more Bollywood A-listers in connection with the probe into what drove Sushant Singh Rajput to commit suicide, the incident that triggered this whole debate in the first place. Take a look at this first.
Closely guarded cliques and age-old networks, nepotism and power play, allegations that have put Bollywood under an unflattering glare. Oscar-winning music composer A.R. Rahman now taking on the B-Town bullies. In an explosive revelation, Rahman says that there are some gangs in the industry that are stopping him from getting work. This comes days after Sonu Nigam, in a sensational interview to Times Now, exposed the music mafia at work in the film industry.
There is a mafia. I don't know how big it is in the film industry because I don't really deal with them, frankly. I am aware of the music mafia. And to tell you the truth, blatantly, honestly, music mafia is way more severe, deadly and ruthless than the film mafia.
The cozy comfort zone of the Bollywood gang on the verge of being shaken up as several voices are coming out in Rahman's support.
This information is very distressing. Although it is very serious, but it is indeed causing a lot of unrest. We are finding that there is some kind of unhealthy competition and groupism in Bollywood, which is causing, you know, throwing dust at each other. People who are investigating such matters must thoroughly examine A.R. Rahman.
In our industry, it's a tough industry to survive. You know, whenever an outsider comes, he should be mentally prepared to grind himself for years. And, you know, if he's able to have that kind of patience and perseverance, then only he's going to survive. It was always there. It's still there and it'll always be there. Our debates are not going to end that nepotism that we have.
And as the debate triggered by Sushant Singh Rajput's suicide continues, the Mumbai police intensifying the probe into what forced Sushant to take his life.
The probe now intensifies in late actor Sushant Singh Rajput's suicide case. Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh has confirmed, saying that director Karan Johar's manager, basically now we understand that the CEO of Dharma Production has been summoned by Mumbai Police. He will be thoroughly interrogated. The manager of Karan Johar, Reshma Shetty, has already been called in and questioned by the Mumbai Police till now. Home Minister also mentioning about it that tomorrow, that is Monday, Director Mahesh Bhatt will also be questioned by the Mumbai Police. The Maharashtra Home Minister has also mentioned about it that if need arises, after speaking to the CEO of Dharma Production, if need arises, Director Karan Johar will also be questioned.
With outsiders exposing the rot, the dark underbelly of the film industry is slowly unraveling. Will the Bollywood gangs wake up and let talent take its rightful place on the big screen? Bureau Report, Times Now.
You're watching the News Hour Special Edition, Debate Number 2, on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
Kasturi Shankar joins us. She's an actor. Also along with her is Akash Deep. He's a film producer and director. Anoop Jalota is a singer, also joins us. And Shibani Kashyap, a singer and musician, completes the panel. Thank you all for being with us. Let me start with Kasturi Shankar. Now, we have heard these allegations of nepotism, of various cliques operating within the Hindi film industry. And let me, outside, at the very beginning, Kasturi, I want to make it very clear that I'm not interested society and only targeting one particular industry, because any sane person who has even slightly aware of him, his or her environment would suggest the same thing. Nepotism, cliques, all that exists in every industry. No industry is completely clean. But the Bollywood industry is now in focus, of course, because of what happened to Sushant Singh Rajput, etc., etc. But if A.R. Rahman, an internationally acclaimed musical genius, comes out and says that there are people bad-mouthing him and making sure he doesn't sign too many movies, then it must be taken seriously.
Let me first register my absolute shock, disgust, and I don't know, I don't have words to express the kind of disbelief that I'm feeling right now. This news broke in the morning, and I cannot believe that a legend like A.R. Rahman, I mean, the guy has two Oscars under his belt. He has nothing to prove to anyone. I would think that to get him to be part of your movie would be a selling point in itself, a status symbol in itself, and obviously contribute to the betterment of the movie. But if movie makers are more interested in ganging up and doing substandard, mediocre work, but, you know, apne kaam se, that is, I'm in disbelief, because, sir, you just told me that nepotism exists in every field and every area. Yes, it may, but speaking for my South Indian industry, in particular my Tamil film industry, let me tell you that, yes, people do use their star power to get doors opened, but there is no nepotism, and I can tell this, I will go on record to tell, there is no nepotism in the Tamil industry or the Kerala industry. You know why? Because the mentality is, people don't respect you if you don't come up on the basis of your talent. If you came up by holding on to a godfather or your own father, people don't respect you in this industry. But I came up on talent.
Kasturi Shankar, even that's a problematic statement, because it's the Telugu industry. We've seen father-son duos come up together.
Telugu is the big exception. Telugu is the big exception where families run, I'm trying to...
Okay, fair enough. I understand where you're coming from right now. Before I go to Anup Jalota and my other guests as well, I want to get in Shibani Kashyap. Shibani, you're a musician, you're a singer, you've seen how the industry works. If somebody like A.R. Rahman comes out in an interview and said that, oh, so-and-so casting director came to me and told me about how people were bad-mouthing you in Mumbai, saying that A.R. Rahman is arrogant, etc., etc. Now, that comes as a shock to the system, clearly, doesn't it?
Yes, absolutely. It's very, very, for us, it's very distressing. And it's something which, you know, we look up to AR, sir. He's a legend, as Kasturi just said, completely a legend. And somebody who's put India on the map, like he's the pride of the nation. I mean, he's won Oscars, he's given such brilliant, outstanding musical scores. And his recent score in the film Dil Bechara is so amazing. It's so superlative. I just really, really, I can't believe that if someone like him is being shortchanged or is being discriminated against or whatever, then it's very, very, it's a path of dark despair for us musicians. You know, we haven't even scratched the surface. We have dreams, and you know, before we can fulfill our bigger dreams, you know, when we if we are to hear such like things, then it's a tough journey ahead for all of us here in the music industry and the Bollywood industry, because of this so-called nepotism and this camp system and this coterie system. But yes, I do corroborate to the fact that this coterie system and this camp system and this so-called mafia system definitely exists, because someone like me, who's been in the music industry for 2 decades now, I'm here, I think, mostly thanks to, my fans' love and my singing, songwriting, ability.
I want to go to Anup Jalota as well. Anup Jalota, you know, there are many people who've come out in the recent past who suggested this clique mentality or this coterie system firmly in place in Bollywood or the Hindi film industry. But you don't associate A.R. Rahman with any of those cliques. He's based out of Chennai. He doesn't really need any publicity. He's not publicity hungry. He's internationally renowned, critically acclaimed. So he's not the kind of person you'd associate with publicity hunger or just saying something for the heck of it. But if A.R. Rahman is suggesting there are people bad-mouthing him and making sure that he doesn't get quality work in the Hindi film industry, you've got to take that seriously. I assume you agree with that. If you don't, please tell me why.
See, I believe that Mr. A.R. Rahman has played a very good inning in Bollywood. Oscar tak pahunch gaye the. Bahut acha kaam kiya yahan. Lekin yahan par zyada kaam milne ke liye Mumbai mein rehna padega. Aapko us circle mein rehna padega. आपको उन लोगों से मिलते जुलते रहना पड़ेगा. अगर शाहरुख खान लखनऊ जाके सेटल हो जाएं, तो क्या शाहरुख खान को लखनऊ से काम मिलेगा?
क्यों नहीं मिलेगा? अब यही तो क्वेश्चन है.
बताता हूँ
अनूप जी,
मैं बताता हूँ आपको.
क्यों नहीं मिलना चाहिए?
अरे मैं जवाब देता हूँ ना आपको. जितने टैलेंट्स हैं हिंदुस्तान के, चाहे बंगाल से आते हैं, चाहे यूपी से आते हैं, सब आके मुंबई आके सेटल होते हैं. अमिताभ बच्चन भी तो आ गए इलाहाबाद से, सब लोग आ गए यहाँ. धर्मेंद्र पंजाब से आ गए, म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर्स सलील चौधरी बंगाल से यहाँ आ गए. सब लोग यहाँ आते हैं, तब यहाँ पर आकर उन लोगों को काम मिलता है. सब लोग एक दूसरे से मिलते हैं, इंटरेक्ट करते हैं. और रहमान साहब को बहुत अच्छा अच्छा काम मिला है, उनको तो कोई शिकायत ही नहीं होनी चाहिए. और अभी भी उनको यहाँ काम मिल सकता है अगर वो यहाँ समय ज्यादा गुजारे.
लेकिन अनुज जी, मैं आपकी बात समझ रहा हूँ, लेकिन एक प्रॉब्लमैटिक इशू ये इसलिए है क्योंकि, मेरी बात सुन लीजिए अनूप जी, आप खुद ही एक जाने माने कलाकार हैं, इतने आपने साल बिताए हैं इंडस्ट्री में, यू आर वेरी फेमस. माई क्वेश्चन इज एंड माई पॉइंट ऑफ ऑर्डर इज सिंपली दिस. A struggler, somebody who's starting out, for him or her to get work, being in the mix is absolutely necessary. मैं आपकी बात मानता हूँ. लेकिन अगर कोई A.R. रहमान जैसा internationally acclaimed musical genius, maestro, चाहे वो जापान में रह के क्यों ना काम करे, उसकी ability, उसके talent के दम पे उसको काम मिलना चाहिए. How is it important if his studio is in Chennai or Timbuktu or Jhumri तलैया? ये 1970 तो है नहीं, टेक्नोलॉजी बहुत आगे पहुंच गई है, फोन कॉल वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग पे सब बात हो सकती है. उसमें प्रॉब्लम है तो प्रोड्यूसर वगैरह मिलके आ सकते हैं. A.R. रहमान कैन फ्लाई डाउन बट ही डजंट हैव टू बी इन मुंबई. दैट इज व्हाई द प्रॉब्लमैटिक इशू कम्स अलोंग. उस पर आप क्या कहेंगे?
देखिए, मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि मुंबई में रहकर रहमान साहब ने बहुत अच्छी अच्छी म्यूजिक दी, पर हर एक फिल्म को तो ऑस्कर नहीं मिला ना. तो हमारे आज बॉलीवुड में एक से एक म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर और हैं, बहुत अच्छे अच्छे काम कर रहे हैं सब लोग, तो उनको यहाँ काम मिलता है. और मैं ये कहता हूँ कि रहमान साहब बहुत अच्छे, उनको आके यहाँ ज्यादा समय अगर वो गुजारे तो सच में उनको मिलेगा. और ये आज प्रैक्टिकली ये मुश्किल बात है
तो
कि
आप,
कोई
तो आप ये कह रहे हैं कि यू रिजेक्टिंग द क्लेम कि कोई उनको बैड माउथ वगैरह कर रहा है. आप कह रहे हैं कि डिस्टेंस की वजह से.
डिस्टेंस की वजह से हम लखनऊ से आए.
आकाशदीप, बिफोर आई गो बैक टू कस्तूरी शंकर, आकाशदीप, व्हाट आर योर थॉट्स ऑन दिस? डू यू थिंक मिस्टर रहमान हैज अ पॉइंट? डू यू थिंक पीपल हु आर नॉट, बिकॉज इन अ सेंस मिस्टर जलोटा इज आल्सो सजेस्टिंग अगर आप उन सर्कल्स में घूमेंगे तभी आपको ज्यादा काम मिलेगा, व्हिच आई थिंक इज पेटेंटली अनफेयर.
See, there are various ways of looking at this. Today, music has almost faded out of Hindi cinema. Films are getting to be more and more natural, more and more real. And the song and dance sequence that comes every 10-15 minutes is more or less over.
But the original soundtrack still remains. The OST is as important as ever.
Hear me out. Yeah, I know, I'm coming to it. Unless it's a musical. So then that's a different story. So it is not financially feasible for a small producer, mid-level producer, to fly down, sign Mr. Rahman, and who would not otherwise want to work with a genius like him? Tremendous respect for his body of work. But A, today, music is not giving you that kind of a revenue back that you can afford the price of a genius, and a genius should come at a price. There's no harm. Music is fading out from Bollywood. And thirdly, I do not agree with Mr. Rahman that there is a gang that is keeping him out. There must be people who must be spreading stories. You know how any profession is. A man is different in front of you. People bitch about one another because it's basically all individuals. We just call it, you know, Bollywood or film industry. We are all individuals. I run a small scale industry. I start a film, I get the finance, I employ people, I make it, I try to sell it, I release it. There is a turnover. So each film is an individual small scale industry. There is no love lost. When, and a lot of times, you know, we've been asked, "Arey, वो रहमान साहब की फिल्म का अगर म्यूजिक फ्लॉप होता है तो फलाने म्यूजिक वाले के घर में पार्टी क्यों होती है, उसका क्या लेना देना?" यू नो व्हाट हैपेंस इज देयर इज दिस नोशनल नंबर वन, नंबर टू, नंबर थ्री. तो अगर नंबर थ्री की पिक्चर फ्लॉप हो जाती है तो नंबर फोर को लगता है मैं नंबर थ्री अपने आप बन रहा हूं, जबकि मेरा कोई लेना देना नहीं.
ही हैज नो कनेक्शन. वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट.
मिस्टर रहमान is not a man with the kind of name and genius, as you rightly said, that somebody is going to tell me and I'm going to stay away from him. Today I'm telling you, I'm giving him a 10 film contract. He won't work with me. Why should he? He would want to work with the cream layer. He's achieved that level. He's an Oscar winner.
No, it's so a very interesting point you're making, Akashdeep. I feel you made a very valid point here, Akashdeep. But I want Kasturi Shankar to respond to this, because Kasturi Shankar, what Akashdeep seems to be suggesting is that Mr. Rahman's genius, his acclaim, his mastery over his craft is way, way, way above most people's stratosphere. He is not that weak that a couple of coteries will sort of undermine him. It might be some individuals might be bad mouthing him, but you can't blame the entire film community in Mumbai for that.
No, I don't think he's blaming the entire film community. Let's be very straight. He's talking about certain gangs, certain camps. But let me go back to something, Mr. Jalota, an honor to be on the panel with him, a big fan. Let me go back to something he said before addressing this question, which is about location, geographical location. अरे हिंदी फिल्म फील्ड में बॉलीवुड में एक ऑन कम्स इन रिकॉर्ड्स अ सॉन्ग बियॉन्से इज डांसिंग फॉर अ वेडिंग सो आई डोंट थिंक दिस इज अबाउट ज्योग्राफी एंड
लॉट ऑफ वर्क यू डिडंट अंडरस्टैंड सर्स पॉइंट एकॉन कम्स वंस इन अ लाइफ टाइम टू सिंग रहमान सिंह आई वांट टू डू रेगुलर एंड डेली वर्क
आल्सो दैट्स द पॉइंट इट्स नॉट लाइक अ शूटिंग इट्स नॉट लाइक एन एक्टर्स जॉब वेयर यू हैव टू बी फिजिकली प्रेजेंट. You have to be their body and face in front of the camera, and you know, you need to go wherever the shooting happens. This is music. Music can be done remotely in today's age and time.
So,
he's talking about the networking. It's not about recording. There are enough and more Bombay heroines working in the Tamil and South industry who still choose to live in Bombay and are number one in their industries in the South. So this is not about location. This is not about geography. It is about networking. And if somebody of the stature, a national treasure like Rahman, has to network to compete with, let me go out and say, to compete with mediocre music directors who are number three and number four and number five.
Okay, interesting. I want to go back to the point that there might be some sort of ambiguity on that. Shibani Kashyap, you are a musician and a singer. How much of a difference does physical presence really make? Because, you know, there are filmmakers. Filmmakers treat the musical aspect or the musical score of a movie as seriously as anything else, be it editing, be it story writing, be it scripting. There is that school who believes that unless you have that kind of vibing with your music director, the music is not really going to come out. Where do you stand on that, first of all?
You know, so I think that in today's day and age, when technology has, you know, sort of progressed in leaps and bounds, this physical location thing really doesn't matter. I have been recording songs for music directors all over the world.
Let her finish, please. Let her finish. The question was for Shibani.
I don't think the location matters, especially in A.R. Sir's case, because someone like a legend like him, I'm sure, you know, he doesn't need to do the networking, firstly. Everybody knows his body of work. Everybody knows what a legend he is. So I don't think he needs to be in Mumbai more to network or anything. But I agree with a few things that Akashdeep has just pointed out, that there might be certain producers who may not be able to do the back and forth from Chennai and Bombay, and or maybe afford a genius like him. So maybe that's where they reserve, their music directors to people who may be upcoming or whatever. So I agree with that point. But I also don't think that A.R. Sir is pointing a finger at Bollywood as a whole. I think he is pointing a finger at certain coterie of
people. Enough. Since I have only a minute to go on this, Anup Jalota ji, ek baat phir se main aapko puchunga. Inne agar bilkul saaf saaf dekha jaye, Yaar Rehman ne kya kaha hai? उनने कहा है कि कुछ लोग मेरे बारे में फॉल्स रूमर्स फैला रहे हैं, इन द सेंस शायद यार रहमान एरोगेंट है या फिर वो काम करने में डिफिकल्ट है, एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. वो तो कोई नई बात नहीं है. ये बैक बाइटिंग वाला जो किस्सा है, ये तो फिल्म इंडस्ट्री के लिए नया तो है नहीं.
सही बात. एक शेर आपको सुनाता हूं. खुशबू को महकने का हक है, खुशबू को महकने का हक है, लेकिन हवाओं से दोस्ती करनी होगी. खुशबू को कौन महकाता है?
Okay, on that note, I believe we've gotten both sides of the argument here, although nobody on this panel otherwise can really dispute the genius of A.R. Rehman. Can I have a last 10 seconds? Okay, go ahead.
With the utmost respect to a genius, and I really personally fond of his music, Mr. Rehman, if he knew from so many years, people are spreading these stories that, oh, he doesn't meet you, he takes six months to deliver a song, you have to sit outside the studio at unreasonable hours. Instead of giving this fight, he could have just come out and clarified that. That's
okay.
It.
Okay.
You wouldn't feel so, you wouldn't have felt like this.
Okay, but the reality is that there is a conversation about the Hindi film industry that has been started. Now, for better or for worse, the conversation should continue. It should not be limited to just the Hindi movie industry, because trust me, there are worse industries that are rife with nepotism, with cliques, as well as a few other words I wouldn't really like to mention right now. Thank you for joining us. Kasturi Shankar, Akash Deep, Anup Jalota and Shivani Kashyap. We'll take a very short break right now. When we come back, the Rajasthan saga continues on the political front. We'll talk about that in just a bit.